Welcome to Pray for Newark's Prayer Talks. The topic of this discussion is the spirit of adoption. I'm Joanne Turner, founder of the Caring Network Volunteer Services, one of the sponsoring nonprofits working with Pray for Newark. In the Transformation in Newark, New Jersey video commissioned by Harvest Evangelism, I stated, as you adopt the city and people adopt streets, businesses, schools, and apartment buildings, the spirit of abandonment, the orphan spirit, will be replaced by the spirit of adoption. And the spirit of bondage, slavery, will be replaced by the spirit of sonship. These phrases came to me as I was praying about the Adopt a Street project in preparation for one of the quarterly street adopters meetings. It's the heart of the Father to love his children. God's Father heart for his children is beautifully expressed in a compilation of scripture by Barry Adams that's available both by pamphlet called The Father's Love Letter and audibly by clicking on the link on our website, www.prayfornewark.org. Take the time to listen or to read this explanation of God's heart. You will be blessed. For more than 20 years, I've lived in a small community about 12 miles outside of Newark called New Providence. In 2007, through a series of events, dreams, and visions, my husband Lloyd and I were drawn by the Lord to join him in a new work of grace in the city of Newark. I'm a registered nurse, and I worked in Newark at the University Hospital from 1988 to 1991. During those years, it was my custom to drive from my home to the hospital's protected parking garage and back, hastening to get out of the city as quickly as possible. As I drove by the boarded up high-rises and abandoned buildings on Irving Turner Boulevard, I felt sorry for the city residents, but was completely uninvolved with anyone who lived in the city. As a matter of fact, in 2007, when we sensed that God was ready to do a new work of grace in the city of Newark, and he was inviting us to join him, we knew just one couple and two of our church's mission partners, World Impact and Michael and Maria Westbrook from Greater Life. We contacted and met with each of these and were introduced to the Resident Ministers Alliance, REMA, through Pastors Fran Huber and Frank Dupre, both of whom we had met through regional prayer ministry connections. Although the themes of God as our Father and we as his children are found throughout the scripture, there are three scriptures in particular that relate specifically to this topic. Romans 8:15 states, "For you have not received a spirit of bondage again to fear, but you've received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father." Then in Galatians 4:5-7, Paul states, "To redeem those under the law, that we might receive the full rights of sons. Because you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, the Spirit who calls out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And since you are a son, God has made you also an heir." In both these letters, the Spirit of God seeks out his people and replaces bondage and slavery with sonship. It is the spirit of adoption that has initiated this process. In 1967, a sweltering summer that will be remembered for civil disturbances requiring the National Guard's intervention, resulted in a flight of all who could leave the city. Jews, whites, and African Americans abandoned the city and moved to the suburban communities around. It was this abandonment that has now been reversed by the Lord. As I began praying for the city and was received by the people that I met, I quickly developed a love for each of them and more for the city. I realized that it was a two-way street. I couldn't adopt the city unless it adopted me. Michael and Maria said it clearly. You can't pray for us without us praying for you. The relational and spiritual riches in the city were exchanged with some of the material and motivational gifts that the Lord had given to us. Isaiah 62:12 states, "You shall be called sought after, a city no longer forsaken." As the spirit of adoption has been infused into the city by more than 1,000 intercessors praying for streets, initially primarily from outside the city, the sense of abandonment has gone and hope is being restored in God's covenant city. This is God's strategy to rebuild our city, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord.